Hi, I'm Tamara, and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today, I'm going to talk to you about borderline personality disorder, and my question for you is, do all borderlines also have paranoid, histrionic personality disorder, and obsessive compulsive disorder? Not the personality one, but obsessive compulsive disorder. My immediate answer to that question would be no. People who are borderlines do not necessarily have these other disorders. And the reason why is, let's take for example, histrionic personality disorder. I heard someone say that borderlines are histrionic personality disorder as well. The reason I say no to that is because someone can have histrionic personality disorder and show no or very little signs of an abandonment issue to the degree that someone with borderline would, and they don't go into rages in the way that borderlines do. However, many borderlines do have histrionic personality disorder tendencies. Histrionic personality disorder criteria: a compulsion to be the center of attention that results in discomfort if unmet, inappropriate seductive or provocative behavior when interacting with others, shallow, rapidly shifting emotions, the use of physical appearance to draw others' attention, dramatic, impressionistic speech that lacks detail, easily influenced by others or situations. So it's an example of, do all or most borderlines show traits of those personality disorders, or do they show the full-blown diagnosis? Now, of course, some people have more than one personality disorder, but if the majority of borderlines show those traits, then is it the truth to attach a full personality disorder onto it? Or should we just say that they also have the tendencies of these other personality disorders? For example, many people with borderline personality disorder have a strong need for attention, like, hello everyone, see me, let me jump up on the table, let me make you notice me, let me stand out. They're gonna do some things that draws attention to themselves, which is what histrionic personalities do, is they have to be noticed. They want to be the center. Why borderlines do that? Perhaps it's to feel real, it's to be noticed, it's to draw people in so that they won't sort of fade into the background and become abandoned. It's interesting that you can see histrionic tendencies in many, many, many borderlines. Look at Marilyn Monroe. And if you look at her childhood, I believe she was in an orphanage or foster home, something like that. And so I'm sure there were some deep abandonment issues, but she was very center of attention, and boy, was she great at it. Would she have both of those personality disorders? I'm not sure. Or simply the tendencies of having histrionic personality. Let's talk about obsessive compulsive disorder. So people with obsessive compulsive disorder definitely aren't necessarily borderlines because they don't have that strong fear of abandonment, but they do have the intrusive thoughts just like borderlines do.
Obsessive compulsive disorder. They must have obsessions and compulsions. The obsessions and compulsions must significantly impact daily life. Obsessions and compulsions are excessive or unreasonable. Obsessions must meet specific criteria. Intrusive, repetitive, and persistent thoughts, urges, or images that cause distress. The thoughts do not just excessively focus on real life problems. They unsuccessfully try to suppress or ignore the disturbing thoughts, urges, or images. Their mind simply generates these thoughts and do not pose a true threat.
Their intrusive thoughts are controlling them by telling them, you need to count how many steps that it takes for you to get out of bed to get to the door. You need to always go back and check 5 times to make sure that your garage is down.
or that you've locked your door. The intrusive thoughts might tell them that they need to stir their coffee at least 25 times to make sure the sugar is in there. I mean, it just is overwhelming. Borderlines also have intrusive thoughts, or some of them. I'm not sure if all of them do, but I've had them to tell me that those intrusive thoughts can drive them absolutely crazy because it's telling them things about people, like, watch out for this person is out to get you, they're gonna hurt you, something bad is gonna happen to you later, you need to have your things packed and ready to go just in case, this person is gonna abandon you, you better operate like this so that they'll stay with you, and it's overwhelming and powerful. I think the borderline has more intrusive thoughts that have to do more with people and their safety, whereas an OCD person, it has to do more with rituals and routines and order and cleanliness even. Like, they may wash their hands 25 times a day. It's just they both have intrusive thoughts, but I think those intrusive thoughts serve more of a purpose. I think borderlines are more driven by their fear of abandonment, while OCD person is driven more by rituals, routines. You have to do this or something bad will happen to you. So, do all borderlines have obsessive compulsive disorder as well, or the tendencies? I would say many of them do. And then the final one that I want to talk about today is paranoid personality disorder. And when you look at the two side by side, some of the things that some borderlines say sound very much like they have paranoid personality disorder also, which they may have the full disorder, or is that just a component of borderlines to have that paranoid thinking?
Paranoid personality disorder. The paranoid personality disorder is characterized by a pervasive distrust and suspiciousness of other people. People with this disorder assume that others are out to hurt them, take advantage, or humiliate them in some way. They put a lot of effort into protecting themselves and keeping their distance from others. They are known to preemptively attack others whom they feel threatened by. They tend to hold grudges, are litigious, and display pathological jealousy. Distorted thinking is evident. Their perception of the environment includes reading malevolent intentions into innocent comments or behavior and dwelling on past slights. For these reasons, they do not confide in others and do not allow themselves to develop close relationships. Their emotional life tends to be dominated by distrust and hostility.
So, can someone who has paranoid personality disorder, do they all have borderline tendencies? I would say absolutely not to that. No, they can be very paranoid about things, but they may not have a fear of abandonment. That just may not be in their scheme of things. But many borderlines do tend to have some paranoia, where they're very paranoid about people being out to get them. Paranoid by different slights. Someone could say one thing and they turn it into a completely different thing. They may say that they have feelings about things, or they have premonitions about things, because it's that paranoia that's coming up, that somebody's gonna hurt me, they're out to get me. That can trigger rages in people with borderline personality disorder, where they are completely going off, yelling, screaming, going off on someone, being very confrontational because they are paranoid that someone has really bad intentions for them, so they go after them. So, do all borderlines have paranoid tendencies? I would say no, because I think there are some borderlines who don't appear to be as paranoid as others are. So I'm not sure if the ones that do show that paranoia, do they actually have the personality disorder, or Is that just a normal, natural component to having borderline personality disorder? So I hope this helps you to at least start thinking about some things, maybe some changes that we can make in the future to give borderline personality disorder more clarity. And for sure, maybe those components, if we're treating someone with borderline personality disorder, if we treat those individual disorders, then perhaps we can make more leeway with helping people to completely heal. So thank you so much for watching my video. Please give me a thumbs up, subscribe below so that you can see more of my videos. Thank you for watching. Bye.